What I want to show you here is, these are the cells that I got on that great find. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to strip one down. These here are ones that I've already stripped, and I'm going to show you how they interact with the spreadsheet I've created so that you can track your cells. You're welcome to use this. Like I said, I do it overkill because I'm just crazy. But it's here if you want it. If not, you know, I get it. It's cool. So with these, you know, you've seen other, I'm sure if you've been out looking around, you've seen other videos of people stripping out laptop batteries or other types of cells. These here were medical grade cells, and they have these, their own little, it's like a little charge controller on here for overcharging, to keep from overcharging happening. So it has this really stiff plastic on the outside, gives it that nice sheen. And then inside, the ends are covered with paper. It's thick and sticky, very sticky. And the tape on the outside here for this charge controller is really pliable. As you can see, I just pulled that right off. And that is the charge controller. Let's see if I can get a little better focus on it. There you go. And all I do is I just go in and strip these back. This isn't a real big deal. I don't want to do a lot of these because you guys will have your own share of cells to strip. But it's pretty self-explanatory when it comes to this. All right, and I clean up some of the nickel that's on here, and I'll clean this paper off of here. It's kind of neat that they put the paper on there to protect the chips as they rest against the cell. All right, so let's set that aside and clean all the gunk off of it. Now we have another clean cell. Went ahead and pulled this paper off on the end down here. Get some of the sticky stuff off. There wasn't a lot of that left. Yeah, it's pretty clean up there. And we'll just pull this off. And there's the charge controller. All right, and I just need to clean off some of the nickel down here, so if I run my hand across it, I'm not going to get poked. All right, so that is the inside of one of these cells. So let's move on to the next piece. I'm going to set this aside, and what I want to talk about is this spreadsheet. You can see I have a lot of different cells in here and a lot of different pieces of information. I'm going to go all the way down here to the bottom because I have a bunch of cells that I need to put in. So I have completed, you'll see this cell here, this 1642 was the last cell that was processed, or last cell that went through here. And I'm going to create a new cell, and this is going to be cell 1343. That's 1343 cells I've gone through. 1343. That way there I can keep track of what the cell ID is on that. Then I take my voltmeter, and I do this after every harvest, not just my new cells, because these are all new. And I know it's kind of overkill for me to do this to new cells, but I really do want to know the capacity. And this comes in at 3.75, and you'll see that a lot of these are coming in at 3.75. They're just being very consistent. So now that I've entered that information, we'll go over here and enter in the harvest date. So this is the 15th. And it is another one of these cells. Now, what this model field is here is I've actually written it so there is a brand and model lookup chart on this back side. And I've gotten as many of them as I can find, and I've tried to gather as much data that I could. There is still some cells that are missing information, or there's cells out there that I don't know anything about. But as I start typing, so I can UR 18650, and then the one I'm looking for is the FJ, so I can select FJ, and it auto populates what its average milliamp hours is and what the brand is. And I know that these aren't really high cells, but they're all brand new, and when I'm through, I will have 1300 of them that I will be able to build into a power wall. So I'll be able to use these for my to run my house. So this here, I'm going to put this cell over here, and all of these other ones here have been harvested earlier, and so I could go through and do the same thing again, where this one here would be 1344, and so on. I just keep adding in the different IDs for these cells. So I got two cells here, and we'll take them over to the table here in a minute, and you can see them go through the charge process. Not that you've never seen a cell get charged before. All right, now then, as cells come off, this one here was, the last one was processed. Once it's gone and been fully charged, the charging units that I'm using aren't always consistent. They don't go to a full 4.2 volts. So what I need to do is, I just put a charge in them because what I'm checking for is discharge. I don't want to see a cell get discharged. So if I have an older cell that came out of a laptop, that's a really key indicator. If you got one that's self-discharging, you don't want it in any of your packs. You want to get rid of that. So in looking at this one here, the charging unit I used charged it to 14.16. So what I'm going to do is go find this ID, which is right here, and it was charged yesterday, so that's 1114, and it was 4.16. So that is now an identifier for that specific cell. Now what's going to happen is I'm going to stick this with the other cells to rest for 14 days. This is going to go into a 14-day rest minimum. Then after 14 days, I'll go through and I will push it using a different charger. I'll actually push it right to 4.2 volts. Then once I get a full load on it, then I run it through my discharge section. And I'll show you that discharge section as well, so you can see how that works. Now this cell here, let's get a good focus on it, has a couple different things on it. This is the cell ID. You notice it's a lot lower because it's actually been sitting around for over 14 days waiting to be discharged. So this is 941 is the cell ID here. When it tested out at 2126. So it's over its standard, because if you look on here, the standard is 2100. So it's actually just a little bit over. It's right in that ballpark. So what I'm going to need to do now is go in my spreadsheet and find 941. So I go to cell 941, a lot of cells going through here. All right, we're down 941. There it is. So after it has gone through its 14-day wait, so there's I put in the date. I then put in at the end of the cell wait period, once, and that's what these guys are going to go through. I'm going to show you this in a second. In fact, I should have showed you these first. This cell here we need to input this data. So you notice right here, it's missing its resistance, which came out to 157, and then its discharge was at 2126. So we'll put in the ohms first at 157, and then we're going to add in the milliamp, or the amp hours, 26. And then once I've entered that in, I have all green across here, meaning that this cell was a good cell. If for instance, this guy came in at, say, 1500, it would come in as yellow, meaning that it's a lower grade cell. It's for testing purposes only. You really don't want it. And even if it gets down around 1000, it goes red, meaning throw it away. Don't even keep it around. It's just my standard. You can set your own for what your levels are. I usually try to shoot for above 1800, but if it's around 15, between 15 and a little bit lower, I'll use it for a test cell or maybe for a flashlight battery, but I'm not going to use it for like putting in a power wall or anything of that nature. So this one is 2126, and it comes in as green. Now, one of the things that I do over here on the right as well is I have three separate columns here. I have used above 1500 milliamps, milliamp hours, and so these are all cells that have tested out positive. So if I come up here, you can see I got just a ton of them. They're all landing right around 21, some over, some under, but it's right in that range, so it's an average of 2100. But as I go back farther into some of my older cells, look here, so I got some cells that tested out 15 and 13, and those are test cells. They're between 1000 and 15. I just use them for test cells. And then even getting back farther, this one here is 1100, so it's a dead cell. Just threw it away. It's not worth keeping. All right, so let's see here. These here I wanted to show you. These are older cells that are ready for discharge. They've sat for a period of time. And let's grab 60, because that's the lowest one here. So we're gonna look for 960. Go down here in my spreadsheet. We should see that 960 hasn't been updated in a while. All right, so what I'm looking at here, oh, that's 860. I guess I gotta learn how to read, huh? 960, I know it's a lot of cells, right? Kind of overkill. So what I need to know, this here I actually did a test on it. So this one's been tested, but 61 hasn't. So I looked at this one and it came in at 4.12 and initially tested at 4.13. And over the course of 14 days, it's only a drop of 0.001 volts. So that's really, really low. So that cell's already in there. Here's 61. I'm gonna put today's date in here, 11:15. And it's been in 15 days, auto corrects itself. And if I look at the voltage on this cell, we're looking at 4.12. And again, it's 0.001 on the loss. So now that this has been, I'm showing that this cell does not degrade over time. It's not, doesn't have a self-discharge. I'm gonna take and charge this up to 4.2 volts completely. And then I will discharge it to make sure that, just to get the capacity. I just want to get the capacity. And again, I'll get the ohms, the resistance on it. Not that I know that that does anything. I just do it because I do it, I guess. All right, so this one here, let's do it again. So 11:15, and it's been 15 days. And its current voltage is 4.12. And again, it's a very, very low loss. And then 63, let's get the voltage on it. Again, oh, that one's just teetering on 4.13. I'll just take the benefit of the doubt. We'll just go 4.12, because it was still dropping down low. See how it's got this value in here? It doesn't know how to calculate it because I haven't put a date in yet. So since I put the date in, it'll calculate that. All right, so those cells are ready for testing. So I'm gonna stick those into a charge mode to get them up to 4.2, and then I'll discharge them. And these cells here, this guy, I think I just need to recharge him. He may already be charged. Yeah, he just needs to be charged, he's dead. So we'll go charge this cell, and this cell here goes into a stack for waiting 14 days. And these other ones here will be charged as well. So now let's go back over to the charge table and I'll show you where each of these cells go.